Hello, Sue here from the Unicorn Advisory, sharing more Kajabi awesomeness with you. Today, we're going to have a look at affiliates. It is a pretty cool way that you can get other people to promote your products for you, and it's a win-win for all. They can earn commission, you can get in front of audiences that aren't your own and make more sales. So, no more giving money to Google and Facebook and all those other channels. You can kind of keep it in a nice little closed circle. And if you know people that have got audiences that are in alignment with your own, then there may be lots of awesome affiliate opportunities out there. Basically, you give someone a special link, it tracks against their special link when someone clicks on it. And if that person goes on to buy, you get a new student, and the person who's recommended gets a commission. It's an awesome system, and Kajabi makes it really easy. So I'm going to go through in this little workshop how you can set up an affiliate program and perhaps start earning some commissions for yourself. So let's dive in. Your affiliate center is here under the sales area. It used to be under people, but now it is under the sales area, which is very cool. So, with your affiliate center, this is where you can get people to opt in to your affiliate program. So, what I recommend that you could do is we have this affiliate page for our affiliates. This is just a page, a landing page that we have built on our site, which just gives a tiny bit of information about the program and also just, a little few steps and a form that someone can fill out. Now, the reason that we do it as a form where someone submits this form to us is that is going to put someone onto our email list, so we will be able to contact them, but we're also going to get some details about them and we can then just check them out, make sure it's someone who we feel would be appropriate to be associated with our brand, and we can then add that person to our affiliate center. Also, it's really handy with this affiliate page is they have somewhere to come back and log in to their affiliate program. So yeah, very, very handy to have that. So that's where someone can sign up for your affiliate program. You could just do something even simpler though. We've built out a whole page. You could simply say, hey, you want to join our affiliate program, and you could just copy this link. I'm just going to pop it in here. Oops. Going to pop it in for you. And this is just going to come up with a simple page. So, obviously, not quite as fancy, but it is going to pop them straight into your affiliate center. You can make it a tiny bit nicer by coming into your settings. In the settings area, you can enable, like, you can add a picture, you can change the wording, but that's pretty much as you can do. So, that's this option here. And, it's nice to add a picture because this is a similar page that will come up when someone logs in to their affiliate center. So we've just got it as a button here, but you can just give out the direct link. So this is enabling someone to register for themselves. That's up to you whether you want someone to go straight into your affiliate program or whether you want to vet them first. Often people who have been students in the past, someone who's already done your program, is a fantastic person to have as an affiliate because they may love what they've done in your program and they'll be happy to share it. It may be a situation where they're already sharing and you're just giving them an opportunity to make some money out of it. So, if you did want to get that login link for someone to log in, this is this one here. So, you can just copy that link and give that out to anyone if you do want to include that in any emails or anything that you send out. So, if you get someone who signs up through a form like this, where you've actually they've come through and on this form that's in our site, it actually sends a message through to Gina, who manages our affiliates, saying, hey, someone signed up and wants to be in the affiliate program. And she's got a whole set of information that she'll send out to people, and she'll then add them into this affiliate area. So you can add people in bulk or you can add them one by one. So you can import affiliates. This is how you add one or many. So you just click on to import affiliate and just put their name and email address in there. So you can see that I have one in there. Oh, something to mention as well is it's quite helpful. Well, I love the way Kajabi does this. They make it really helpful. It's going to say that they're going to be emailed this affiliate user welcome email. Now, if you click on this, it's going to take you to those ugly Kajabi template settings, like the transaction emails that are under settings. So click on this. It's going to take you through there so you can fancy it up and make it a little bit nicer. All right. So, so that's for getting someone into your affiliate program. Once someone is inside, they will be able to access any links that you give them access to. Now, there is a really cool feature. This is new in the Affiliate Center. And I must admit, for someone who has a lot of products, I love it a lot. Previously, you would have to go into each individual offer and set your commission percentage. But now you can go through and change your commission and turn commission on and off in one simple place. Oh my gosh, it's so much easier. I'll show you how to do it in both. But yeah, when I discovered this, I was like, all right, it's never being done in there ever again, unless you're setting it up and you think to do it at the time. Okay, so we've got our mini course here. So let's say we want to do 50% commission. Now, just speaking of commission from a business strategy perspective, the more commission that you can give someone, the more likely they are going to promote your products. So generally in the course and membership space, somewhere around 40 to 50% commission is the most appropriate and the most common. If you give someone 10% and they might make $15, they're probably going to be a little reluctant to really, really push what you're doing. One thing that I have seen with people where they're offering a front end offer, like a challenge, a paid challenge, and then they're going to be selling a bigger course off the back of that, is that they might even offer 75% or sometimes even 100% commissions on that initial small offer, knowing that they're potentially going to make money in, you know, on the other side of that. Now, if you are running a paid challenge, it can be a really good idea, you know, to get people to really promote that for you, because otherwise you may need to promote it with ads, which potentially are going to cost you the same amount as your small ticket price anyway. So it can be a really smart way to do it, but make it relevant. If you're doing a coaching program, you're probably not going to want to give 50% of that away, but if it's a recorded course and it's on Evergreen, and you know, there's not a huge amount of direct input from you, then that can, you know, work out the percentage that you might feel appropriate charging or giving away. Okay, so you can go through and update these. So we'll just make this one 50. We might make the membership 40. And usually with memberships, and the way that it is structured in Kajabi is that it's an ongoing payment. So every month or year that that membership is paid, the commission keeps getting paid out. One thing about the Kajabi Affiliate Center is it's quite simple. There's a few things that I would love for it to do that it doesn't do. However, having set up affiliate programs in other software, I do really appreciate the simplicity, because sometimes it can be a massive headache to set them up. And even though Kajabi doesn't have as many bells and whistles as I would probably like with customization options, it's really easy. You can just go through here. I'm going to show you. We'll just come down to here. I'm going to save those ones. This is now going to save this commission. These are our products that are that we have commission. So if you did want to do it one by one, or you wanted to do it when you are setting the offer up, that's a really easy place to change. Maybe you could do a special and you could, you know, increase your commission during a special offer period. That'd be a pretty cool way to encourage people to promote. So you can come down here and you can also go into this after purchase area and you can click on give an affiliate commission here and put the percentage in. So that's another way that you can do that. All right, so we've got our setup here. Now this is where you share your links. So you come into your links and this is where you actually will choose. So you have to set the commission up, but that doesn't automatically give someone the link in order to be able to share it. So you actually need to come and set the links up. So what happens if someone clicks anywhere on your site, if you just direct someone to the homepage and they then go on to buy one of the products that you do have affiliate commission set up. So, so let's say Patrick is an affiliate of mine. So Sue, it's my site and Patrick is my friend and he wants to recommend someone to come and buy one of my courses, but that person isn't really sure. So he just gives them the general website. So let's just say, unicorn advisor. There we go. I've already done it. And what we want to do with that one is we want to give a landing page. Now, we could do a custom URL, which is really interesting, but we're going to do this one as a landing page. So we're not going to go through to an offer, and we're just going to make this one home. Hopefully I have a page in this testing site. We'll go sample home. There we go. So let's pretend that was our home page. So even though Patrick may give out the link to the home page, which will let someone, you know, explore around, maybe they can, learn a little bit. Maybe we can even set up a link to a freebie, like an opt-in or something like that. If the friend of Patrick's, the person that Patrick recommends and gives his link to, buys anything that you have an affiliate commission attached to within 30 days of landing on the site, then Patrick is going to get that commission. So it doesn't necessarily need to be just to your specific offer. It could be to the sales page. Like I said, it could be to the freebie. Maybe you are running a webinar or something like that. So you're getting people to advertise your free thing, and then they'll make money when someone goes on to buy. At this point in time, you can't change that length, that cookie window is what it's called. I really hope they Kajabi will change that. There was a survey a few months ago, and it was like, could we just make it whatever we want, or lifetime, or, you know, 60 days, 90 days. So I suspect at some point they may change it. But right now, the length of the cookie period, the active period that someone could purchase within, is 30 days. So if you get someone to start promoting within that 30-day period, then they will be able to make that commission. But it doesn't have to be. If your commission, say, is on your membership, you don't have to give them just a link. So this one here, we've done a landing page link to a freebie opt-in, and then someone can give out that link and they will be able to still get that commission tracked back to them. So what I would suggest that you do is go and create your links. You can do a direct link through to the checkout, but what I would suggest that you do is you link to the page that you would normally send people to. If it is a webinar registration page, do a link to the webinar registration page. Sometimes, like for example, with our templates, so there we go. So I've got the Kajabi template shop, all designs, 25% commission. So actually write in what the commission percentage is, because you can't put a whole lot of information in here. So people will know that if they use that link, they're going to get that commission. And then you can direct that to wherever you want. So you could direct it. So for example, for the Kajabi template shop, we have a link to the general shop, which is like all of the designs. And then we also have links to specific ones, which can be helpful if people want to recommend specific products, like in a blog post or something like that. So, you know, giving people options is nice. There is an option for hiding the link from affiliates. You can use that if you want to. It's kind of like a pause if you don't want to delete it, but you just don't want it there for a while. You can do that as well. So you can go through in this affiliate center, set all your links up, and then when your affiliates log in, they will get a dashboard and it's going to show the links on there. Now, that link that they see is going to be their own individual link, which is pretty cool because it's going to track back to them. And then what's going to happen, and I don't know if we're going to see this on here because we don't actually have any transactions, but what will happen is you can come into your transactions and it's then going to give you, so we don't have any sales, so it's going to then give us a list and tell us who made the sale and how much it was and what date and what offer. And if you have a lot of commissions going through, you can export that into a file and you can actually import that into PayPal in order to pay those commissions out. So Kajabi doesn't automatically pay your commissions out. You still need to process that manually, but you know, you'll see exactly how much that you owe to each affiliate, which is pretty cool. So yeah, and it will you'll be able to track your conversions and conversion rate. If you have any forms, it will track those, how many people are clicking. And when you do go into each user, unfortunately, it doesn't say it on here, but if you actually go into that person's name, then you will be able to see how many clicks are actually attached to them. And if you did want a particular affiliate to earn a higher percentage of commission, or perhaps have that, you know, that they earn more than other people. So this is also an example of the links for that person. So if someone's like, oh, I don't know where my link is, you can go into their account for them and say, hey, here's your link. So if you really want to sort of, you know, give your affiliates encouragement, make it even easier for them and give them their own individual links. Obviously, that will depend on how many people you have and how many links. But yeah, that's, you know, you've got options. It's so basically, this is the code that's been attached for that particular person. So it's going to create their own special link. Affiliate marketing is so incredibly powerful. It is such, such a great thing to incorporate into your business. I strongly, strongly recommend it. So yeah, that is the affiliates. Now, one more thing is, if you want to communicate with your affiliates, a couple of ways to do it. So you can send out an announcement, which is going to go out to every user. This is really similar to the announcements in the product, but even more basic. So we've got this announcement here, title, body. That is it. There is an affiliate announcement email template, which is under our settings and email templates. So there's not a heap that you can put in here, but you know, it's definitely worth using. And if you do have people that you have registered in your affiliate program and you've got them tagged as an affiliate, you know, if you did have a form like this form here, we'll tag people as an affiliate when they fill it out. Then you could also back it up with an email that goes out from your marketing email system. So that is something to bear in mind. It just reminded me of a very important point, is that people who are in your affiliate program, the affiliate program is completely separate to your actual people CRM area. So if a user goes into this affiliate center, it is not going to automatically put them into your people area. These two are very separate. So anyone that is a user here could set themselves up with a completely different email potentially than they could in people. So these users and these users are on two almost kind of like different systems. So yeah, so that's why I would suggest that sometimes it can be helpful to send out an announcement and to also back it up with an email that goes out. And if you have people that are going through and filling out the form, then you can have a welcome sequence for your affiliates as well and give them some helpful tips and some more information about your products. And the more that they know and the easier you make it for your affiliates to promote you, the better it will be and the more that they are going to send people your way, which is always very, very nice. All right, that is affiliates. Now, it is only available for growth and pro plan. You won't be able to use the affiliate center if you are on the basic plan. But yeah, it's a great way to set it up quickly. It's all linked back to your Kajabi checkout, and you know, hopefully it's going to continue to improve like so many aspects of Kajabi. It's one of the things that I really love the most after using other systems is the constant and continual updates and improvements and new features and you know, cool stuff that happens within the software itself. All right, have a beautiful day, evening, morning, wherever you are. Bye for now.